My name is Lynn Jacobson, and today I'm going to tell you about my product called IdeaGuide. It's an application for the iPhone. I'm going to tell you a little about what I have done, what I'm doing now, and what I'm planning to do for the rest of the summer. So, the problem I saw that inspired me to do this project was that I get a lot of ideas, I know other people do as well, and quickly it can look like this. Just write it down on notes. Or it can just be a mess on your computer. So I thought maybe you could do something that's a little bit different. And when you get ideas or inspiration, it's usually on the go. So I thought the iPhone would be a very suitable device to do such an application for. So to start out with, I did some research. First of all, I want to understand, is it only me who has this problem, or how do other creative people work with ideas? So I looked a little bit into like how graphic designers work and how writers and stuff like this. Same thing, they have a process of gathering ideas, and I found out that they use words like visual research, information gathering, and one author actually wrote about kept an idea book. So it lived on to, it's not only me, it's this need. And also that, because my initial idea was just to write down ideas, but then I thought, okay, maybe ideas, inspirations are not only written, it could be an image, it could be a drawing, it could be sound as well. So after this, I start to write down what should this application contain, what function should it have, and wrote down these functions. It should be able to write, record, paint, take pictures, save the idea data, analyze it, make a list, visualize, and you should be able to hit then delete, and you should be able to search. Because a very important part of it for me was that you can visualize your ideas somehow, and maybe you could see new patterns. Like if you plot like your ideas according to time, when you got them, or location, or other things. So I looked a little bit into how can you visualize, and of course there's, I don't know how many different kinds of visualization you can get, can use, but these three were some I liked. This is a dream map, and this one's just an XY plot, and the last one is a histogram. So then of course the next step is, is to what kind of method of technology should I use to visualize, and I looked on the internet on what methods you can use to visualize. I know there's there are frameworks you can use in the iOS if you want to do some graphic, but I thought maybe I could learn from other projects that already did some kind of graphic. So I find a lot of projects, and I sorted them here. Like, some are frameworks some other people did, some are iOS classes, some are based on the web. So I left this a little bit behind because it's kind of later in the application, and I realized if I want to write something and save it, I need to have kind of somewhere to store it. So I looked into the Core Data framework, and I was able to do this data model, and got it to write something, and you can save it. But it's very low stage. So last week I started to work a little bit on how the application should work between the different views. And to start with a kind of black box of the visualization, I just want to see how I could work with putting in some text, get it out in a list or something like that, and learn from this, and then build on to the graphics later on. But actually while I did this, I realized the list is maybe not that bad a function to have, so I think I will leave it in there. I was actually planning to do a demo for you today, but it's not quite finished, so I will just explain what I was trying to do for these views. So the first view should be like kind of a blank page, just text. And then it will be built with a title, and there will be automatic written the location and the date and time of where you wrote this, and you could be able to put some tags on. So you can save this quickly, and then you can move on either to search in your bank of ideas, and you can maybe you can search the location and you get the list here. Then you can tap the idea and bring it. Or you can just go to some auto-generated list, so it should be location, time and date, and text.
So how do you input the text?
It's just there's a way I wrote it is when you tap this, there will come up a keyboard, and you just this is very explained. Yeah, so where I'm at now, this is where I'm at now, and I struggle a little bit with getting the interaction between the different views, but I think I will get this settled this week. So the next step is to kind of determine what kind of method I want to use for the visualization and what type of visualization, and maybe add a new level of complexity to the application later on. It could be like draw, photo, sound. I need to look into this just time.
So in the data model, do you have scope for including a photograph or something?
I try to do the model very simple, so it could be easily added like similar structures. So to start on with, I made this plan for the project, and I pretty much followed what I said I would, but I realized so you need to do some changes in your plan. But this is my plan. I made the first phase. Between the second and third phase, so the next thing is visualization of the data, expansion of more visualization. I like to test the application and maybe I find out some other addition in the last phase to release the application. So that's what I have. I don't know if you have any questions.
Yeah. Have you looked at Evernote? I mean, it seems
I did some research because maybe in the first or second week I thought, oh, maybe someone else came up with this idea. And as you say, Evernote is a very clever application and service altogether. And I saw there were some similarities, but I still feel that I have something that's different. And I try to keep it very simple. Yeah. And the Evernote is kind of, they want to take everything in, right?
So what, are you writing the search mechanism yourself, or is it part of the data and the database that whatever database that you use that takes care of the search?
I'm not really there yet, but it's a good question.
The reason I'm asking is, can you add tags when you write your ideas?
Yes.
So you can add tags so that the searching that ideas will become easier. So if
yes.
You can add some tags, then you can question the tags and then add outcomes ideas. That's what
I'm saying. Exactly, yeah. Maybe I have one question for the crowd, is that if anyone has experience with visualization, maybe what's the best thing to use?
You want to do some visualization?
Yeah, but I don't have a sense of that now.
Okay,
this is a lot.
Yeah, I understand.
So this is for me. Are you using any standard toolkit for visualization?
But one thing I really like is the Google Jam. I think another good talk about that. last Friday, and they have many different, very nice looking visualization tools. So I'm thinking about using that, but I think I need to look in like kind of the criteria I want to evaluate them from, because there's, I found maybe 10 different ways to do it. So.
So if you come out, you say they can look through, they can, I mean, you know, they can chat up with see the demo.
Yeah.
And by the time I log, also they will show, see the demo.
Yes.